for this section, we're really only looking at domain and range of linear functions. The way that you tell a graph is a function, instead of just looking at the ordered pairs, is you just take your pencil. So let's say this is the graph of a line, and you take your pencil and you run it vertically down the line. So let's say I was sliding my pencil this way, and this is my pencil laying here. As long as your pencil only crosses in one spot at a time, then it's a function. So this is a function. All your lines that are in the form of mx plus b, they're all going to be functions. So let's suppose we have maybe the graph of y equals 2x plus 4. So I'm going to graph the y-intercept, which is this one. And I'm going to go, the slope is 2, so that's 2 over 1. So I'm going to go up 2 and over 1, and I'm just going to draw a line. Okay. And the way you find domain and range, see, let's change this color a little bit so that we can make it a little bit easier to see. Domain is the value of all the x's, and of course if you have an ordered pairs, you just list all the x's. But when you have a line, you have an infinite number of x's on this line. Like, you have the point, you know, 2, 6, and 4, whatever, and if this line keeps going, 6 and whatever, and 0 and whatever, and it just keeps going and going, so you can't really list all of them. So what you do is you say, how far does this line travel down my x-axis? That would be the domain. And when you keep trying to find a point on this line just keeps extending. So if I try to find an x value, it's just going to keep going. It's going to keep going out to the left, and it's going to keep going out to the right. There's no beginning and there's no ending because it just goes on forever. So when something goes on forever like that, you say that it starts on the left at negative infinity because that's as far to the left as you can go, and it ends on the right at positive infinity because that's as far to the right as it can go. And you put these parentheses around it because you can't actually find the point infinity on a line. Now, if it had been a point, like if this line had stopped at the 6 and it had been a definite point, you'd put a bracket around it. But this one goes on forever on both sides. Every line that's in that format, so like every slanted line, its domain is going to be negative infinity to positive infinity. Every range for a line, the range is the y value. So this is your y-axis. And when you try to find the points on the y, you know, here's your line that's extending. If you try to find the points on the y, it's just going to keep going and going down this way, and it's going to keep going and going this way. So the same thing applies. For range, it's also going to be negative infinity to positive infinity. So your linear functions, the lines, so everything that's in the form of y equals mx plus b, unless it's a horizontal line, they will all have a domain of negative infinity to positive infinity and a range of negative infinity to positive infinity.